Namaste. Greetings from Swami Vivekananda Yoga Deemed University at Bangalore to all our friends in Visva-Bharati Shantiniketan. I congratulate you for organizing this program on the occasion of the International Day of Yoga. This year, International Day of Yoga is going to be unique, with all of us celebrating it as home practice with our families. Thank you for inviting me for this program, in which I hope to give you some insights into how yoga can be useful in lifestyle change through yoga for respiratory system to be strong, with strong immune system to cope up with the COVID situation. Slides, please. We have been going through many pandemics. We thought that, in fact, these pandemics of infections have been repeating almost every 100 years. And in the last two decades, there have been three major communicable infections in different parts of the world. But none of them have been of this degree of severity with pandemics. In fact, the earlier two endemics were also through the similar virus, coronavirus, but not COVID-2, but they were COVID-1 and MERS-2. So communicable diseases are becoming pandemic. When we were already talking about non-communicable diseases like diabetes and hypertension being pandemics. What could be the reason why we are going through such a big problem in spite of so much of technological advance? It's purely because of the scientific world looking at our body like 10 blind men looking at an elephant, because each person looks at one person for the eye, one person for the heart, one person for the lung, but none of us have the holistic vision. Looking at COVID-19, we call this COVIDA. COVID-19 is a COVIDA. COVIDA in Sanskrit means experienced, skill, learned. It's posing such a big challenge to all the big brains in the world which we are facing. Our body has enormous capacity to fight against the COVID-19 infection through our immune system, which is distributed all over the body with inbuilt quick emergency border security forces in the form of innate immunity and long-term adaptive immunity, which will last almost lifelong, as if there is a big messenger. There are three major fighters in our body which help us destroy the virus once it enters our body. Cellular fighters called T cells, NK cells, which gobble up the virus and destroy it, and chemical fighters called antibodies, which lock up the virus, and antioxidants, which neutralize the stress toxins which are produced heavily in the sinuses around the nose, which are all protective. According to yoga, we understand COVID as an anadhita vyadhi, which is due to cause which comes from outside, and therefore we tend to think that the remedy is outside and try to do medicine, surgery, etc. But even in anadhita vyadhis, there is the triangle of health. It shows that the viral count is very important. If somebody coughs on your face, thousands of viruses are thrown on, which enter our respiratory system, and therefore we would need antiviral drugs in the form of hydroxyquinoline, etc., which is being tested. Of course, there is no specific medicine yet discovered for the coronavirus. But what is important for all of you to know is yoga helps in improving our tolerance to the environment, which is aggravating the situation. Stress disturbs our immune system, and immune stamina are all improved by yoga. Stress disturbs our immune system working, and we know the whole pathway, starting from when we get fear, tension, how it works on the brain, what chemicals are involved, which nervous system is stimulated, how it works on the immune system, how it decreases the immune capacity to fight the germ, or aggravates it, creates a big imbalance which may by itself kill the person. And all this has been very clearly understood. And what we need to do is to understand how this can be changed by changing the lifestyle of the individual, how it is related to the mind of the individual. So lifestyle has been very clearly recognized. Yesterday I was talking to one of our friends who is in the task force for handling Karnataka cases in one of the big hospitals, Victoria Hospital. He said out of the 200 patients who get admitted, 20 people are sick with cold, cough, etc. But 8 people are in the ICU with an oxygen mask, none with ventilators. But amongst these, 1 or 2 deaths that happen are because they are all very elderly people with associated diabetes, hypertension, respiratory problems, smokers, etc. But he says there was only 1 person who was a 30-year-old who died of this coronavirus infection in this unit because he had a very bad lifestyle, alcoholic, smoking, irregular lifestyle, poverty, and so his system was so disturbed and vulnerable that it killed him. So lifestyle is very, very important to prevent the infection, keep the respiratory system very healthy and strong. And what is important for all of us to know is whether it is junk food, lack of physical activity, or bad habits, or stress, all these are traceable to the mind. And therefore, mind is the root cause of aggravation or vulnerability, transmissibility of the virus to others. And in the mind, what is it? It's all our stress, the negative emotions of intense craving for smoking, intense craving for junk food, which can lead to intense anger, intense fear, frustrations, and attachments, jealousy, etc. Negative emotions, which are all responses to demanding situation, which are persistent and long, can cause lot of imbalance. And this concept of Panchakosha Viveka, where the body, the respiratory system which is getting affected, is in the physical body, which we call as Annamaya Kosha, which is controlled by prana, the life energy body, which has to flow very, very harmoniously to each and every cell in the body to keep the health of the body, much more so the immune system and the respiratory system. This pranamaya kosha is controlled by mind, in which all the problem begins. Violent, aggravated mind with emotions is the culprit which prevents me from staying in our discriminating faculty and remaining in that blissful, quiet, enjoyable state. So the tissues that are getting damaged in respiratory system are all managed by prana. So prana flow to the respiratory system in the right quantity. Too much kills the person, too less kills the person. Therefore, a balanced flow of prana is what is very necessary, and helping the person to maintain mind-free state in the blissful silence is the one which is going to help them. The sages want to make us understand that it is the violent, aggravated, uncontrolled speed of the mind which has to be handled. And the definition of yoga itself is mastery over the modifications of the mind, which has to be handled kya hoga, mujhe disease aa gaya, is the speed which one has to be mastered by kya hoga, mind slowing down trick, which is called prashamana, which leads to balanced functioning. And therefore, the summary of yogic management of this respiratory infection or respiratory allergy or respiratory vulnerability to COPD, etc., are all through giving local, deep, conscious, wakeful rest to each and every cell in the respiratory system, which is done by several of these techniques. Deep relaxation technique, instant relaxation technique, quick relaxation technique, etc. So we recommend all these lifestyle programs, including diet, cleansing techniques, and asanas. What are the asanas that are recommended for improving the respiratory stamina? Backward bending, forward bending, twisting. These are very useful for youngsters to do Surya Namaskara. Surya Namaskara done several rounds is going to harmonize our energy, give the exercise effect, and help us in stabilizing the whole system very systematically. We also teach Shithili Karana Vyayama, fast exercises synchronized with breathing to keep the general stamina, keep the muscles strong and fit. Then we go on to teach some instant relaxation technique where we tighten the whole body in the supine position and then relax. Then 3 minutes of abdominal breathing type of relaxation called QRT and whole body relaxation of 5 minutes through DRT. Neeti is being very much recommended in COVID infection by masters, because it's going to cleanse the virus when we come back home after being exposed, if at all. Even if you are waking up wearing a mask, there may be some chances of it touching your nose. Therefore, come back home, do Jalaneeti if you are a trained therapist. Otherwise, don't try to push them. Simpler way is just do Ushapana, drink water through the mouth, not plain water. Lukewarm saline water like we use for Neeti, and smear oil to the inner surface of the nose. Vamana Dhauti, Shankha Prakshalana are all very useful in this COVID period, which is being recommended even by the Ayush Ministry. Pranayama is very important, removes the imbalances, right neck balance. Abdominal breathing is the most useful type of breathing practice, which helps to keep the diaphragm going. I'll show you the example of a person who has used this to survive. In Manomaya Kosha, we use mind sound resonance technique or yogic resonance technique, in which we resonate the cells so that all the toxins are removed and brought to the kosha of the abdominal region, and cells become totally free when they enjoy the resonance of the sound that is ingrained when we chant, when the lady chants akara, akara, makara, etc. Pranayama is very important. Devotional session is very important. Lot of research has been done in respiratory problems during acute phase also. And we have been working on this for the last 35 years to teach yoga to people with various respiratory disorders. So these are some of the practices which have been evolved, which is being used in our centers. I just want to end by sharing one or two examples of Dr. Neeraj Patil, who was a London mayor who survived a major infection because he was serving. All the politicians in London had picked up the virus, and so he picked up the virus in spite of all the PPE, etc. And he was going on to becoming very distressed with his breathing, and he says he used antarkumbhakar, holding the breath after inhalation type of pranayama to come out of this. And he was a great Shiva Bhakta who had installed the Shiva statue when Modiji visited London. So this Shiva Bhakti saved him. Another example is a family in Vancouver. All the family members picked up the infection, but only one of them became sick and she was kept in the quarantine in the hospital. And she says she was able to completely recover from going, instead of going forward into a ventilator, she could come back home to her own inner home, the peace, the livelihood, the joy of being in touch with your divinity. All these she picked up and she was able to completely come out. Before I end, I would like to share this knowledge from Dr. Giorgianiara, who was a cardiac, who is a cardiac surgeon in Milano, Italy, who sent me a mail which is very touching. I thought of the yoga center with little oxygen in my brain. You made me think besides my surgical science. Surgical science did not help him. As a doctor and patient with COVID, fighting for life with each breath after breath. In a moment, there was light and courage when I just started doing that 3 minutes practice that we had sent as a message as early as April, where he was doing 1 minute of fast breathing, 1 minute of slow breathing, 1 minute of Brahmari, completely relaxing the whole mind-body complex. And through that, he was able to come out and look at his touching experiences sharing. Although 120 Italian doctors died to whom I was trying to incorporate yoga, I could come out of my deathbed by using yoga, and I dedicate my life to India. So these are some of the statements which help us to understand how immune system and respiratory system have to cope up with the COVID infection and work on that. I wish all of you all the best so that you will be able to incorporate this in your own lives and give this knowledge to everyone. And on this day of International Day of Yoga, please practice the common protocol from all the houses and promote this. So this year going to be a unique IDY when all of us do home and family yoga instead of gathering in thousands and millions in different parks and stadia. Wish you all the best. Once again, I thank you and giving your greetings and best wishes for the success of this program. Dhanyavaad.